The upcoming Ahsoka series is going to be a Star Wars Rebels sequel in many ways. Rebels is one of the best Star Wars shows out there, and it's a great addition to the Star Wars franchise. Today I want to talk about the connections between Rebels and the Ahsoka show. Which stories are important for Ahsoka and the whole Mandoverse? So please subscribe to this channel for more cool Star Wars videos, and let's start with the first story. The most obvious story that is going to be explored in Ahsoka is the question, where are Grand Admiral Thrawn and Ezra Bridger? In the end of Rebels, Ezra and Thrawn were pulled into hyperspace by the Purgels, the space whales we saw in chapter 17 of The Mandalorian. The trailer showed us Ezra and Thrawn, so their story is going to continue in Ahsoka. It's going to be really interesting on how they are going to do this, because the time between Rebels and Ahsoka is about 10 years. So Ezra has been missing for almost 10 years. Ezra is not the little kid anymore, he's a grown man. There is a lot of room for great storytelling here. Same with Grand Admiral Thrawn. What is he doing in these past 10 years? Why didn't he return to the Empire? A lot of questions that need answers. Ahsoka and Sabine are teaming up to solve these questions. Another story that is going to be continued is the team up between Ahsoka and Sabine. The Rebels epilogue showed them meeting on Lothal to begin their search for Ezra and Thrawn. And thanks to Star Wars Celebration and the trailer, we know that these scenes were recreated in live action. This is probably in one of the first two episodes because it's such an important moment for the story. It would be a great start for the series. This search is going to be interesting because I have no idea on how it's going to look like. For the most part of the series, we are going to be in the unknown regions of the galaxy. Like the name said, it's not much known about this part of the galaxy. This search could be similar to the Rebels episode Legends of the Lasat, where the Rebels crew find a new home planet for the Lasat species in the unknown regions. Another Rebels character that is making their live action debut in Ahsoka is Hera Syndulla. We are going to find out what's going on with her. In Rebels, we found out that she is still part of the Rebellion. She fought in the Battle of Scarif and the Battle of Endor. And thanks to the story of Star Wars Squadrons, we know that she is part of the New Republic. The New Republic is going to be important for the Mandoverse and that time frame. We saw Mon Mothma in the trailer, and we know that Hera and Mon Mothma are friends and allies, which could be important for this story. She is probably a big ally for Ahsoka when Thrawn returns to the galaxy, which I believe happens in this show. But that's not everything about Hera. The Rebels epilogue also revealed that Hera and Kanan Jarrus had a child together, Jason Syndulla. Even though it's not confirmed, I think it's safe to say that he's going to make an appearance in the show. I mean, it was a big deal at the end of Rebels, so it would be kind of weird to ignore that here in this show. The main planet from Rebels is Lothal. The trailer confirmed that this planet returns in Ahsoka. We could find out what happened to this planet after the Empire was defeated. We know that Lothal has a deep connection to the Force, especially the Loth-Wolves. I'm sure that this show is going to do some crazy stuff with the Force and with Loth-Wolves. Another concept that was first introduced in Rebels was the World Between Worlds, which is very likely to return in this show, and it has a deep connection to the Lothal Jedi Temple. These trailer shots could actually be in the World Between Worlds. I'm not sure how this would fit into the story, but I'm certainly interested in exploring that concept more. Maybe it helps with the search for Ezra, who knows. Another story that I'm 100% sure will continue in Ahsoka is the story about Ahsoka and the Skywalker family. This story goes way back to the Clone Wars movie where we first met Ahsoka and her becoming the apprentice of Anakin Skywalker. During the time of Ahsoka, I want to see her processing the events of Anakin turning into Vader. Does she know that Anakin redeemed himself? Is she disappointed in her former master? I want to see that relationship continue. I mean, it would be kinda nice to see a Force Ghost Anakin. I'm not saying I'm expecting it, I'm saying that it would be cool and appropriate for the story. We are also talking about multiple Skywalkers. The Book of Boba Fett showed us Ahsoka and Luke Skywalker together. I also want to see that relationship grow. If you are interested in Ahsoka and Luke's relationship, I did a video recently about a big team-up between Ahsoka, Luke and Ezra in the Mandoverse, so please check that video out if you are interested. The next story was mostly covered in The Mandalorian, but I think it could be important for Ahsoka as well. We are talking about the Mandalorians versus the Empire. Rebels had a lot of stories with Mandalorians, like Bo-Katan getting the Darksaber, Gar Saxon being killed, or the Protectors of Concord Dawn, and much more. Sabine Wren, one of the main characters in Rebels and Ahsoka, is literally a Mandalorian, so we could explore more of that in Ahsoka. Also, Mandalorian teased Thrawn during the Shadow Council meeting in Chapter 23. The connections between Ahsoka and the Mandalorian are obvious. So maybe some of these Mandalorian Rebel stories continue in Ahsoka. So far, every member of the Ghost Crew is confirmed for Ahsoka except Zeb and Kanan. Kanan will probably not appear because he's dead, but I think Zeb's story can continue in Ahsoka. I mean, they knew what they were doing in Mandalorian. Zeb had a cameo in Chapter 21, The Pirate, and we want more of him. And there's someone special in Zeb's life, his name is Kallus, once an Imperial, now friend of the Rebellion and New Republic. I would love to know what happened to Kallus after the Rebels epilogue. I think an appearance of Zeb is more likely than Kallus, but this story is worth telling. We all want a Rebels reunion on screen in live action at some point in Ahsoka, so Zeb has to come back for this. Zeb is a member of the New Republic, and as I mentioned earlier, the New Republic is going to be a big part in Ahsoka. The last story for today is Captain Rex and the clones. Rex is a fan favorite character and one of Ahsoka's best friends. I would be really surprised if Rex doesn't show up at some point. There were reports about Temuera Morrison playing Rex recently, but nothing official. It would be really cool to see a post episode 6 Rex. We know that he fought in the Battle of Endor, but that's it. Is he finally in retirement or has he one last fight in him? And let's be honest, we all want Rex to show up in Ahsoka. Nobody can deny that. And I believe these were all the stories that are going to be important for the first season of Ahsoka. In the future, I plan to do this kind of video with Clone Wars and other Mandoverse shows as well, so please subscribe to this channel for more cool Star Wars videos and leave a like on this video. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, may the Force be with you, always.